running quarterbacks. They said they put up good rushing totals against the guys. What was it Saturday that made their kid effective?
Of course, a lot of people will see the game and think it's the rain, but it just comes down to us. What we did, what got fits, all that stuff has to deal with it. He came in, got 169 rushing yards. Coach never liked stuff like that, but he came in, did a good job. You just got to tackle better. That's all basically it was. Just got to tackle better.
They were sort of two different, obviously the tackling and how well he played, but Coach, they were running basically standard plays, things you're used to. Did they do anything unusual, or they ran?
As soon as they brought in number 11, you can see like their mindset, they running in straight downhill, straight running ball, that's all it was. So it just came down to execution and tackling. That's all it did.
We'll go to Norm.
More on the running quarterbacks, it's nothing new for you guys. It's, I guess, six quarterbacks in the last since the start of 2014 season at 94 yards or more running against you guys. Is there something repetitive that's happening in these games as far as, not being able to set the edge or middle of the field or something? Is there something that's an issue over and over again that you guys have been able to put your finger on?
I want to say is that just as soon as the game's over and we watch film, Coach tell us after we're watching the plays, there's stuff that we could have done better to stop what they did. That's all that came down to execution. Coach Ross always going to put us in the best position, the best plays, just for us to go out there and have them execute his plays. But, all it came down to, we make from him and start running the ball, rain a little bit, but that's no excuse for anything. Tackling could have been way better. And we just try to make plays. That's all it is. Sometimes you're in the game, you try to just do a little too much. I know I messed up on a few plays, but like it was just execution.
What's it like to defend a player when you see the missed tackles on film? What's the feeling, and how do you go about correcting that?
It's just bad knowing that if we did make the tackle, the play would have been over, and he would have never got that many yards. So missed tackle is a big thing. Coach always put us on like pride and like tackle the best defense. You got to go up there hard. Like missed tackle is just, you can't do that on Coach Ross' defense. One missed tackle is pop the play wide open. So it's just execution.
Raise your hands, we'll get to the microphones. Okay. We'll go back to Jason.
Deon, I guess you guys are, at least for a half, down to your third string linebacker there with Andrew being out, now Sean being out. Does that make any kind of difference having a true freshman in there next to you?
I mean, it really don't make no difference if it's a true freshman, junior, freshman. I mean, same thing. But Coach Ross are always proud of us, man. You can be the next man, and no matter what, if somebody go down, you always got to practice like you're the next starter. But Carson, he came in, did what he had to do, made three tackles, but just a few plays, but here and there. But Coach always proud to be the next man, practice like you're the next man, no matter what. Don't take no plays, don't be when you're in practice, you're not doing plays that started. If you're on the sidelines, you got to like mentally get the reps all day, no matter what. So. Oh yes. As soon as we seen the flag, the whole defense was mad. I mean, Sean did what he had to do. Quarterback was running to him. Sean, he just leaned in a little bit, but he didn't even really hit him on the head. But it's just one of those calls that you really can't judge that bunch. But they blow him out, but he's gonna come back next half and just do what he gotta do to stand back.
Stay in the back of the room.
Yeah, first of all, I do appreciate your time. And so I've got to ask you again, going into conference play, you've already got four non-conference games under your belt. Just talk a little bit about the feelings and mindset going into conference play. You guys still have the goal of winning a conference final.
Oh, Coach always brought up, like, next game is the biggest game, no matter what, if it's a conference game or not. But, we definitely got to win out if we want to go to the ACC championship. And just always proud of us being that Virginia Tech offense and defense that we always got to just go out there, go hard, no matter what, give no plays off. Every game is just another step, another chapter in our book. We just got to close in the right way.